at practice, I was thinking about this. But you're on the news, yeah, they see about this. Even in the paper, they gon' read about this. Cause over my life, training day and night,
I'm preparing
to fight for everyone that believe. Crowds going the same, yeah, they screaming our name. Bottle spraying champagne, nothing nobody can say. Cause today is the day. Is the day that I have always dreamed of. Into the camera, tell my mama I love her.
Set to my favorite song. All green lights on the road I'm on. Man, there ain't no doubt I'm getting
Kiss make it worth it.
We keep it on the up. That's how we get down. So don't be coming around unless you got them good vibes. I'm living this good life. I'm breathing on God's time. And I ain't gonna waste one breath. I'm soaking in.
May our hearts be full like our dreams tonight. May we sing and dance till we lose our minds. We are only young if we see tonight. Tonight, we only
know. I love it! I love it!
Time.
Sora. I'ma bought a credit card made from NBA floor. It's game time and I'm in the pros. Nah, me and your ex can't have the same score. Tryna hit the end zone from the friend zone. And maybe bring friends to the end zone. Hey, it's up to you when we in Syracuse. Get you out and cool you down, I got the damn flu. We gon' make it rain, rain, rain. Like we won a championship game. We gon' need some more champagne to take it all away. It's about to go down. In a minute, let me touch down. I'ma get it. Cause I been waiting all night to make it go from the friend zone to the end zone. Tryna take it to the house, baby, let's go. Cause I been waiting all night. It's game time. Step back, hit him with the shake. Crossover going hard in the bank. Hit that money in the bank. All star, watch me do it all day.
People moving so fast like an airplane. Madness in the air trying to chase the sun. I was thinking for tonight, we can take it to the stars. It doesn't matter where you're from, it's all for one dream. You'll never be the same once you become a champion. So hey, this is our time.
sunset match. Time to put it in your past. Oh, I feel the winds are leaving. It's redemption season. Long live the young and high. Cheers to a brand new start. We're evolved and breathing to live a life of freedom. Oh, to everyone who's hit their limit. It's not over yet. It's not over yet. And even when you think you're finished, it's not over yet. It's not over yet. Keep on fighting. Out of the dark into the light. It's not over. Hope is rising. Never giving in. Never give up. It's not over. Yeah.
And we begin right now with that big development, Utah schools sending students home for the next 2 weeks.
Pandemic has also canceled spring sports, at least at the high school level, and it's a tough pill to swallow, especially for these high school seniors out there.
When the dogwoods start to bloom and the crickets hum their tune, it's usually about the time that I feel most alive. But the news has all been bad, and the world just seems so sad. I ain't had much else going on, so I sat down and wrote this song. I miss my mom, I miss my dad, I miss the road, I miss my band, giving hugs and shaking hands. It's a mystery, I suppose, just how long this thing goes. There'll be crowds and there'll be shows, and there will be light after dark someday when we aren't 6 feet apart. First thing that I'm gonna do, slide on in some corner booth, take the whole damn family out, buy my buddies all around, pay some extra on the tab, catch a movie, catch a cab, watch a ball game from the stands, probably overwash my hands. I miss my mom, I miss my dad, I miss the road, I miss my band, giving hugs and shaking hands. It's a mystery, I suppose, just how long this thing goes.
Mason, man, I can't believe this time is here already. You've grown up so fast, and we've had so much fun doing so many different things. You've really blessed my life and our family in so many ways. I'm so proud of you for all you've accomplished, and I'm proud of who you have become as a man. I know baseball has taught you many lessons, and they will help you throughout your life. It has been such an honor to have coached you for so many years. Thank you for being a good leader and teammate, working hard, being coachable, and always competing. I love you, buddy, and I'm really going to miss you.
Mason, I've had a blast making so many fun memories with you. Backyard wiffle ball started at 3 years old, and baseball has never stopped for you. There was a time I remember when you were about 13 years old, and you didn't have a ride to practice, but you figured out your own solution. You put on your cleats and you sprinted off, pulling your bat bag behind you. It was a catcher's bag. You ran all the way from our house in Nibley to Zollinger's Park, and you were climbing over fences and going through fields. You just didn't let things stop you. I laugh thinking about it, but I also see you as a kid that you never complained, you persevered, and you were determined to follow through. Baseball has not only brought you so many fun opportunities, but a lot of good lessons learned. And you've made good habits to take with you through your life. You've continued staying positive and making future goals, even through all the adversity of many injuries and now this season being cut short. You're a leader and people look up to you. You've always been a peacemaker with such a great heart, and you've looked out for others and you've been a friend to everyone. I'm so proud of you, Mace. I love you so much and I'm really gonna miss these days, but I'm really excited to see what the future holds for you.
Daxton, first off, I want you to know how proud I am to be your father and to be your coach. I've watched you through your highs of hitting your first home run, winning your first championship, beating the Spanish Fork Angels with a one-hit gem, and I've been there through your adversity, dealing with your lows. The plantar fasciitis when you were 12, not being able to run around the bases, losing the Little League Championship in Providence, losing the state playoff game. I want you to know that baseball teaches you everything you need in life to help you succeed and help you strive to be a better man. It's been a pleasure watching you play. Your mom and I love you, and we're excited to see what the future holds for you.
Kid, I never thought I'd see this day come so quickly. Way back to starting baseball with the Orange Men at 8 years old and all the way up through your senior year, what a ride it's been. It's been amazing to watch you grow and mature, not only as a baseball player, but especially as a young man. I can't tell you how proud I am of the young man you've turned into, both on and off the field. You're an amazing young man, and I love you so much.
Cade, I have loved every minute of watching you play. Even through the early years of moping on the mound, you have grown and developed into an amazing baseball player, and I am so sad I won't get to cheer you on for your senior year. I know how hard you have worked and how much you were looking forward to this year. This year's Ridgeline team is special and has so much potential, and you are a big part of that. I know you love this game, but your future is bright, and I can't wait to see what great things you accomplish. I love you so much, and I am so proud of you.
They see it now, you weren't built for backing down. Boy, there'll be a small town night, and you'll fall for her sky blue eyes.
Tyler, where do we even begin? When we think of your childhood, baseball is the first thing that comes to mind. You truly were born to play ball. From that first pop and pitch to at the age of two being able to throw the ball up and hit it over or through our fence, to your nickname of Benny as the Sandlot was your favorite show, and you would dress like Benny the Jet Rodriguez.
To us happened to sing Take Me Out to the Ball Game each night as we tucked you in. To you at age six playing Super Bowl were the memories of countless Saturdays and tournament weekends began, where you pitched your way to many finals and trophies, and to the countless plays you made at shortstop, and to you, your love of the Boston Red Sox.
To you getting your dad down to the ballpark nightly to pitch you buckets of balls to fulfill your goal of hitting one over the fence at age nine. To the countless teammates and lifetime family friends made through baseball, to the many coaches and fans who worked with you, believed in you, and supported and cheered you on as you advanced in your talents and love of the game.
To the hundreds of loads of dirty baseball money, to your high school baseball career, where you gave it your all for your team and pitched through arm pain, then worked through arm therapy to get you back just enough in time for the following game the next week, to your awesome junior season, and then to the final injury and surgery that ended your high school career even before the pandemic did.
Tyler, we are so proud of you and all that you've accomplished with your sports and throughout high school. We have been your number one fans through it all and will continue to be there for you always as you close this door and begin the next chapter of your life and beyond.
Tyler, you're smart, talented, kind, so much fun, and have all the potential in the world. Dream big and follow your heart. Love, mom and dad.
Brandon, some of my earliest memories of you from when you were little are with a ball in your hand, throwing it to anyone you could find to catch it. Even before you were ready and old enough to be signed up for sports, you would beg us to let you get signed up to play. Every time we drove by a ball field, you would ask when it was your turn to go out and play ball, insisting that you were ready. I have always appreciated how, even during the toughest games, you have been able to remain a good sport and stay calm under pressure. Your dedication and perseverance to give every game your best and to never giving up has been some of the best things playing sports has taught you. Brandon, as your mom, I have been the luckiest to have a front row seat in watching you grow and become not only a really great athlete, but more importantly, a really wonderful son that I'm so glad I get to call mine. I'm excited to see what's ahead for you.
Brandon, it's been fun watching you grow and develop your talents over these last few years. I believe you learn from sports hard work, consistency, toughness, personal responsibility, and teamwork, and a passion to win and be successful. Vince Lombardi said, it's not whether you get knocked down, it's whether you get up. Winners never quit, and quitters never win. These lessons that you've learned will continue to be a strong foundation in life. I'm proud of who you have become. Thanks for all the memories.
I think the best way to describe Otter is small in stature, but huge in heart. From a young age, I think he realized that in order to compete, he was going to have to outwork everyone. We've never had to motivate him to try and give it his best because we knew that he would put in the time and put in the practice, whether it was on his own or with his brother, and trying to become better. We love that he has never been afraid of failure and again goes out and does his very best. We have thousands of memories of watching him play from his first home run to saving the game defensively, and we'll cherish every minute watching him in the field. I think we're most proud of Otter for the fact that he is a great teammate. Whether it was getting up off of the bench first to go out and celebrate with his team. And same thing when they came around and scored. Just wanting to be involved with his teammates. And the last thing I'll just mention about him is that he is a very fierce and loyal friend. And we definitely missed watching the boys play this year.
Another turning point, a fork stuck in the road.
Jace Carter, I've put this off because I am just not ready for this moment. Everything changes, which is not a bad thing. I'm just not ready for this moment. But you are. A song keeps coming to my mind. Winds will come and they will blow. They'll try to shake you, but I know you'll be just fine. Jace, the reason I know you'll be just fine is because what I have already seen with you. You have had hard trials, such confusing, heartbreaking, and unfair hardships to deal with. Make the best of this test and don't ask why. It's a lesson learned in time. I feel you've done this. I've watched you want to better yourself, staying optimistic and positive. That right there has made me the most proud. It has been a lesson learned in time. Moving to Providence was a very uncertain time for you. Steve Pond letting you have a chance to play for the Orangemen was, I feel, one of the best things that could have ever happened to you. Not only did you get to make some awesome memories, but you also made wonderful friendships that will last long past high school. What awaits you in these next couple years can be very uncertain and scary. At the same time, also exciting. Here is where we will see what is really in you, and I can't wait to see what the future holds. My best advice to give you is, let your faith defeat your fears. And whenever you feel alone, just know I'm right here.
one of my all-time favorites that has stuck with me since my high school is the song from Green Day. It's something unpredictable, but in the end it's right. I hope you have the time of your life.
Aiden, congratulations as you finish your high school career. Your family loves you and is so proud of you. Baseball's brought so much joy to our family throughout the years. So many good times, so many good teammates, coaches. Take all the things you've learned from baseball, your passion, your energy, your attitude. Be on time. Be the best father. Be the best husband. When you're struggling to get a hit or compete for a position or make a team, remember those feelings and how you overcame those. Do extra things. Be prepared. Take that with you in your life when you have hard times or you're struggling, and use that. Remember how it feels on game day, and take that with you to job interviews or moments in your life to help you along the way. We're proud of you, we love you, and we're so grateful for Ridgeline Baseball, your coaches and your teammates, and we're gonna miss all of you. Thank you.
Aiden, I want you to know how much I love you and how proud I am of you. I know how hard you have worked to achieve this moment. I know how hard you have worked at everything you do, and I know you will continue to work hard. Aiden, go after your dreams. Dream big. Believe in your dreams. The world is in your hand. Now go after it. I'm excited to see what this next chapter brings you. Congratulations and best wishes. I love you, son.
It's always too fast. There'll never come a day.
Andrew, I have loved watching you play sports for the past 4 years at Ridgeline. You have worked so hard without a break, except for when you had your injury, and during that time you never complained. You have become an amazing athlete and have put your whole heart and soul into everything you have done. You are as tough as nails. You have great sportsmanship, and you have encouraged others to be their best. I love you, and I'm so proud of you.
Andrew, I've enjoyed watching you and coaching you play sports. You've lettered in 3 sports during high school, football, wrestling, and baseball. I appreciate your coaches and others who have taught you so many things that are going to help you in life. How to be a team player, sacrifice, hard work, and especially helping and assisting others to do their best. I'm proud of you. I love you.
It's how they live their lives. In the dash between. In the dash between.
Peyton, it's so hard to believe that you're finished with high school and ready to take on the world. We want you to know how proud we are of you, and that we know there are so many important things still in store for you. You've always been such a great example to your family and everyone around you. You amaze us with your knowledge of sports and stats, but most of all with your ability to bring people together, make us all laugh, and your love for everyone. Peyton, when you were about 6 years old, you got smacked in the eye with a baseball bat. We can all see that that didn't deter your love of baseball one bit. The whole quarantine situation has been a little bit of a knock to the head for you and everyone else, but it hasn't stopped you. I hope you'll always keep that attitude and keep pushing forward, even when things are hard. Please remember to keep learning all you can, working hard, and being someone we all look up to. Don't stop until you're proud. We love you, and we're so proud of you.
You work to be the best. Now you've got your shot. Taking every opportunity to give them everything you've got. Never will you surrender. Never will you fall. Never will you break down under the pressure of it all. You did it all with purpose, and we'll holler as we stand, 'cause we're so proud of you. For everything you do, oh, we're so is how we choose to remember, to remember, to remember just where we were. To remember, to remember, to remember just where we were. Some go down in history, destined from the start. I just hope I'm standing there when you're laying down your mark. Born to be a hero, above the rise of man. Beneath the breath of many, echoes the greatness in the land. You did it all with purpose, and we'll holler as we stand. 'Cause we're so proud of you. Just where we were. Oh, 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 oh. Remember, yeah. Oh, 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 oh. We'll holler as we stand, 'cause we're so proud of you. Not just for the glory, but for everything you do. We're so proud of you. Oh, you've given us a story that forever we will use. Because this is how we choose. This is how we choose.
One, two, three, four! Oh.